Hello students, welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding Dare We Begin to Hope, written by Akhil Bilgarami. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to begin from the basics. Now, what do I mean by beginning from the basics? That we need to understand of how the concept of state has evolved, how the concept of citizen has evolved, how the concept of government has evolved. Now, as far as the beginning of the concept of state is concerned, as far as the institutionalization of the state is concerned, it was preceded by the inception of the feeling of nationalism. It was nationalism, it was the feeling of nationalism that has given way to the creation of states. States and the nation states. So the nation or a state is created because there is a feeling of nationalism. And in this feeling of nationalism, there is a kind of a hope. There is a kind of a desire. There is a kind of a expectation. Expectation from whom? Expectation from the state. So actually it is the expectation, desire, hope and the vision that creates this force of nationalism. And this force of nationalism, it ends up creating something tangible that we call it as the institution of state or a nation. Now, in order to run this state or a nation, a government is created, because it is the government that will fulfill the expectation, the desire and the hope. Desire, hope and expectation of whom? Of the citizens. So if we go by the theoretical concept, citizen, a person becomes a citizen of a nation only and only if a state is created. And a state is created because there was a feeling of nationalism. Now this is all that is actually involved in the entire process of providing legitimacy to the government. Now, in order to fulfill the expectation, desires and the hopes of the citizens, these governments, now what are these hopes, desires and expectations? Hope to have a good education system, to have a good health system, to have a good transportation system, to have a good criminal and justice system, to have access to the social services like the pension scheme, like the insurance schemes, to have access to the tangible assets, land, cars, computers, houses, drinking water, etc. So these all are the hopes, desires and expectation of a citizen from a government. Now why I'm going and why I'm going into so much of depth of about all this, why I'm delineating about all this, I'm telling you all this because if we want to understand the current phase of development, if we want to understand of what the governments are doing presently, we need to go back to the theory to understand about the cause of the legitimacy of the governments. Now, as far as the current phase of development is concerned, now these governments, they promise to its citizens the development. Development is nothing but the hope, the desire and the expectation of the citizens, that it will be providing all these things to its citizens. But the current phase of the government in which we are currently placed in, it is not providing us all these. The current phase of the development is not guided by the hopes, desires and expectations of the citizens. When I am talking about citizens, what I mean by citizens, I mean that everybody is equally placed and the expectations, desires and the hopes of everybody should be met equally. There should not be an inequitable distribution when it comes to fulfilling their desires, hopes and expectations. Now, among these citizens, we have a certain group of people who are well off, who are capitalists, who want to grow more, who want to be bit more big than the rest others, who want to create a hiatus. Now, it is this section of the society that is guiding the government the world over. So the present, at the present juncture where we are standing, the all the governments in the world, they are being guided by this capitalist class. Now they are fulfilling the hopes, desires and the expectations of this class, and the citizens, they are not getting all this, and the governments, they have actually mortgaged the education system of the country, the health system of the country, the social services system of the country to this capitalist class. Today the government of India is not providing it, providing us with a quality education. It is not providing us with the healthcare system. It is not providing us with the transportation sector. But on the other end, we end up paying every moment to the government. By recording this class, by doing this class, and you by watching this class, are actually paying the taxes to the government in the form of the service tax that has been increased from 12.6 to the 14%. Buying this pen, I end up paying to the government, and buying a Kurkure packet, again I end up paying to the government. By walking on the road, I again end up paying to the government in the form of the toll taxes. But the government, the current government, the current governments that we are having, they have actually made themselves timid. They have actually shrunkened their scope of working. They have actually changed their nature of working. They have actually mortgaged the hopes, the desires and the expectations of the citizens to this capitalist class. And what is this editorial? Dare we begin to hope? So in order to create a next paradigm, in order to bring about a change in this current phase of development, we need to think differently. We need to create an alternative form of development. We need to strengthen our governments. Now, why the governments? They are actually giving away everything to the private sector. Why the natural resources are getting apportioned by the capitalist class? 50 years hence, nothing will be left with the governments. Nothing. Only they will be able to just collect the tiny taxes from the people. Apart from that, the resource generation capacity and the capability of the government is going to shrink. So we need to challenge the way the development is being carried out. Because at the end of the day, the nation exists only on the hopes, desires and the expectations of the citizens. Till the time the feeling of nationalism is there, there will be a nation. Once this will get evaporated, the nation will break. We have seen this happening in Germany, in Italy, in Vietnam. We have seen this happening in the Middle East. We have seen this happening in the countries of South America. So this is all pervasive. So the legitimacy of the government lies in fulfilling the desires, values, and the expectations of the people. fulfill their hopes and sustain yourself. So the next paradigm of the governance, of the development that the government should be introducing, it should not be based on inflating the private sector. We have had enough of the private sectors. We have seen the full river doing its course. We have seen how the capitalism has operated during its upstream, middle stream and downstream. Right now we are lying at the downstream phase. We have done the critical analysis. We need to introduce the change. So this is all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-940-000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. Now, for the information on the classes that we are offering, you can visit our website, that is eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. You can also install our application. You can find that application from Google Play Store. This is for the Android users, and on App Stores for the iPhone users. So this is all for the day. And in case you've liked this video, please do click on the like button, do share and comment this video. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice night.